Hi everyone, I'm Raymond and welcome to my channel, Interior Design with Ray. Have you ever wondered what goes behind the scenes during an interior renovation? Are you getting the best deals from your designer or contractor? How about your space planning? Is your layout as plain as the gym next door? And with the wide arrays of materials in the market, do you know what's best for you? So I hope by watching my videos, you'll be better informed before you start that renovation journey of yours. In my channel, I also share with you valuable interior design ideas, tips and tutorials. In today's video, I'm going to bring you to visit a 3-room HDB apartment which I did some refurbishments. Let's find out.
Okay, first thing, take a look at this feature wall. Right, it's finished in lamination. So you can see that when there's two pieces of laminate joined together, there'll be a black line here. For this color laminate, the black line is not too obvious, right? Just from this angle. But if it's like white laminate, then yeah, probably you would have to touch up the edges. The console top is also in lamination. It's like a dark wood laminate. So the edges, right, is in ABS aging, which is about 1mm thick. So the reason why we like to use ABS is because it's lesser of this black joint line. So you can see that these two suspended shelves are quite thin. Right. It's quite sturdy as well. Basically, my carpenter has inserted the metal rods into the wall, right, to make it more sturdy. I think a lot of carpenter wedges suggest doing like this thick and thick, so that they can actually add some wood frame support at the back. It's like a tongue and groove joint, right, and then just insert into the tongue. But that won't be so sturdy, right? Because when you press, it's edges, right? It's going to be quite loose. Storeroom door, right? You can see that basically when it closes, right, it flushes with the wall, right? From the angle here. Right, the thing that I'm not too happy about is there's these two cutting edge at the bottom. Right, you can see that, right? It actually follows the skirting profile, which doesn't look flush at all from this angle. So let's take a look inside. Right, if you look at the door frame, right, the door frame is supposed to go all the way to the floor and cover the skirting, right? Instead of just hanging above the skirting, which is not so nice. So I've asked my carpenter to redo this part here and also this part, right? So he has to trim off the door and perhaps redo a new one. Okay, the layout of this kitchen cabinet has not changed much, right? It used to be a L as well. Okay, so you can see that there are all the power point wiring coming down, right? So basically this wall here is going to be finished with glass, in colored glass, right? So the owner is using back his existing hob, right? It's a new sink here, right? So you can see that this slot here, right, basically is for the washing machine. The washing machine used to be here, right, and I think it's a bit tight, the space. Okay, this slot is going to be the washing machine, yeah. Right, the power point at the back, right, it's like sharing with, it's actually below the sink. You can see that I've done a flip up panel, okay, with a shelf which is removable, so that in any case if there's choke at the floor track below. Right, I've also done the door here. Right, there's ways to, you know, unchoke the floor track, right? So the finishing of this kitchen cabinet is all in white laminate, right, matte finish. You see the edges are also finished in 1mm thick PVC. So you can see that there's this, there's no black line, right, because it's using the ABS trimming. So it looks neat and nice, okay. Except that there are certain areas where, right, you see some black line, which is, you know, unavoidable, because these are like big panel of laminates. So you can't finish this with like multiple ABS trimming here, right? It won't look nice. So over here is just a little storage for the washing machine detergents and stuff like that. Okay. Soft closing. Okay. This is the master bedroom, and then we are walking towards the, it's like a walk-in wardrobe. Alright, so what I've designed is three sides walk-in wardrobe. Alright, this is all closed with a little niche. Right, and in the middle there's four niches. Alright, some storage on top, storage below. These are drawers. Right. External drawers instead of internal drawers for easy access. Yeah, this is right, it's just some hanging inside. Okay. Okay, for this, right, for this corner door, you can see that that's my carpenter to do it this way, right, so that you can easily access the corner. Right, normally corners are always like a dead corner. Right, and then you put things in there, you can't reach, but right, you forget about it. So this is like for easy access. Okay. So this is an open store, open hanging, right, which is finished in like a fabric colored PVC finish. Yeah, it's very nice. No black line here. Alright, so this four niches, okay, including the open hanging, right, has got a like an LED strip running below. Okay, so this is a vanity mirror and the vanity top. Right, a bit constrained here because of all the exposed pipings done by HDB. So all these pipings, there's no way to remove. Right, so mistake here is basically this height here is a bit too high. So I'm going to redo this part over it down. Right, so that it's not so high, yeah, it's a bit too high. Right, so simple design on the door. Scrap the edges here, open up the door. Okay, the door has been modified. You can see that now the door frame is straight down, right, overlapping the skirting. And then you open the door, right, everything is just straight and nice down, right. And so at least there's no more cutting edge at the corners. Okay, the quartz top has been installed. Right, this is quartz, right, with a thickness of the profile is 15mm. Unlike solid surface, right, where you see that the joint here is actually curved. Okay, the reason is because quartz is harder, right? There's no way they can grind to make it curved. Okay,
managed to clear up the place a little bit. Let's clear all the paper and stuff. And look at this pile of rubbish. Oh my god.
Hi guys, I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please like, subscribe and hit that bell button to watch my future videos. Stay safe and see you soon.